Okay, thank you for the invitation and organizing this great workshop, especially in Asia, because I haven't been in Asia for 4 years. And you may notice that I can't stop smiling because I'm surrounded by many Asian people. Anyway, so let me start with a brief introduction of our company first. So Slamcore is a very small startup, which is a spin-off from Imperial College London in the UK. And then 2 months ago, we successfully completed our seed funding investment, backed by this capital is one of the top venture capital in the UK as well as in Europe. And Total Research Institute is an independent research arm funded by Toyota, and Sparks is a Japanese venture capital. And we have 5 co-founders, except Owen Nicholson, who is our CEO. Four of us have been working in a visual slam for quite a long time, especially including Andrew Davidson, who is our chief scientist, is a pioneer in visual slam, and Dr. Stefan Rutenegger, who is our CTO, who is the expert in sensor fusion and flying robots. And by looking at our member of co-founding team and then the name of our company suggests, we do slam, simultaneous and localization and mapping. And although the Andy and Davide introduced slam nicely in this workshop, let me say that SLAM is a technology that gathering measurement from all different sensors. In our case, we specialize in the visual sensor like RGB camera, depth camera, even event-based camera, as well as inertial measurement unit, IMU. And developing algorithm to answer 2 fundamental questions in SLAM. Where am I in this 3-dimensional world? And what does my world look like? And this kind of SLAM technology has evolved a lot and has enabled all many practical applications these days, including AR, VR, drone, autonomous vehicle, and robotics in general. So as I said, the technology has evolved a lot, but we believe that there are still fundamental technology challenges left. So for instance, how we can track really rapid motion so that we can develop a drone which can track skier without crashing into the ground, as you can see the top left. And if we apply to the autonomous vehicle, how we can deal with various real world lighting conditions, like a very bright sunlight, as you can see top right. And then how we can minimize the latency between the sensor measurement to the output control output signal, so that we can develop a kind of a VR device which make their user cannot feel any kind of latency, which make them really sick when they use that kind of VR device for a long time. And more importantly, how we can deploy our SLAM algorithm running on a very compact and low power platform so that we don't need to recharge it every few hours. And then we believe that because we are good at algorithm, SLAM algorithm, but we believe that by just improving algorithm won't change that much. Because a SLAM system consists of 3 key elements: sensor, processor, and algorithm. So we believe that the innovation needs to be made in all different 3 sectors. We need to go together. So we defined our approach to tackle those challenges step by step. And this is aligned with our prediction for the hardware landscape. And for instance, we can say that we have a CPU or GPU as an existing processor. And on the way, we have some kind of a dedicated processor which is good for computer vision while consuming much low power, like Intel Media 2, all the way up to IBM Trunos type neuromorphic processor or graphic processor, something like that. And similarly, for the sensor, we can say we have an RGB camera, IMU, depth camera as an existing sensor. And recently, we heard many times that other sensor manufacturers develop a really good a new sensor consuming much less power, provide high frame rate and high band range, and all the way up to event-based camera. So to be honest, our company Slamcore is not focused on event camera only. More focus goes to the core SLAM development. So we want to develop a modular SLAM system so that we can apply or optimize our algorithm to all different types of embedded system, utilizing, of course, traditional sensor and processor, but more focusing on near-term mobile sensor and processor. And then, in parallel, we do have an event-based SLAM R&D part. And then we treat event camera as a complementary sensor. And then eventually, we want to make it as a kind of a sub-module of our core SLAM system. And then we want to go toward ultimate SLAM solution, which will be running on a very compact and low power hardware platform by integrating sensors and processors and algorithm very close together. That's our final goal. But we believe that that's several years away. So let's focus on what we are doing for event-based SLAM, because it's all about for this workshop. So, you know, I would like to emphasize, because we heard so many things about event camera already, so we are experts now, but I would like to emphasize that four superior properties of event camera: high measurement rate, high data range, low latency, low power consumption. And this gave us high potential to solve all kind of the challenges I mentioned, only if we come up with a good algorithm and supported by the mobile processor as well. So far, we have developed Beatdown 2D. It's a pretty much same method that Andy explained in the morning session, but it learned in real time on a standard laptop now. So it tracks three of camera handle and camera motion, and recalls 2D map as a kind of parallel scene. As you can see, this blue flying rectangle represents the rotating field of motion, and then we can show that it can track quite rapid motion as well, and then we can reconstruct our scene at a very super resolution. And we extended to Eatime 3D, which is a real-time event-based six-dot tracking and 3D mapping method. So as you can see, if the handle of the event camera is observing kind of a desktop scene, we keep producing artificial keyframe consist of the intensity gradient and intensity and the 3D depth, so that we can represent our world as a kind of a 3D semi-dense point cloud, as you can see in the middle, while we are getting the kind of old trajectory of the camera as a graph. So some highlight of those methods is that by harnessing the superior properties of event camera, if the situation involves a lot of rapid motion, we can track that motion while we are reconstructing scene without motion blur effect, while we are getting a severe motion blur from standard camera. And if scenes contain high dynamic range, we can cope with that while we are reconstructing high dynamic range scene, as you can see here, compared to the saturated conventional frame from standard camera. But one of the limitations of the current Eatime 2D and 3D method is that it requires a decent GPU to reconstruct intensity in real time. And then when we think about how we can apply our method to a computationally limited platform, then obviously we need to get rid of that kind of GPU requirements. That's why we have been working on how we can track directly the estimate gradient without needing intensity reconstruction. And here is a kind of a preliminary result showing that now we can track without reconstructed intensity. Of course, if application allow to have a decent GPU, then we can reconstruct intensity. Because we believe that by keep estimating 3D structure as well as intensity, then it will allow us more high-level tasks in the end, like object recognition or loop closure. And we show here as a kind of example that we can do feature detection and matching based on the two artificially generated keyframes here. And today, from this workshop, we have seen that many event camera manufacturers show that neural event-based camera providing much higher resolution and higher sensitivity and a smaller form factor, especially Samsung TVS. So we were lucky to have a chance to play with all these different cameras. So I'd like to thank Inilab, Insightnase, and Samsung to give us that kind of a chance. And then here is a kind of a example, what kind of more information we can get from that kind of neural defense camera. So here is the comparison of the intensity reconstruction using three different camera. One is a DVS-128, middle one is a Insightnase SDR-1, and the last one is Samsung DVS Gen 2. So clearly we can see that whenever we have a higher spatial resolution and higher sensitivity, we will get more information so that we can create the concept more detailed scene, as you can see here. But as a from the usual perspective of event-based camera, I would like to share there's a kind of challenge for us. Because if we have a more higher spatial resolution, it will produce more event rate. Right? So for instance, so those numbers, 0.5, 1, 3, don't matter that much because event rate depending on the scene and motion and the setting of the event camera. But point is, whenever we have a higher resolution event camera, it will produce more event data, right? And especially our method still based on event-by-event processing. So there is a certain limitation we can process in real time. So based on that, we need to, when we develop event-based SLAM system, we need to think about how we can process that kind of a higher data rate in real time. And that we have been trying to achieve for a while. And then, as I simply mentioned that we now treat event camera as a complementary sensor. Because so far, we have been using just a single event-based camera, mainly because academics want to solve hard problem, or it has a more meaning in academia. But that was a kind of joke, but no one laughed. But but more important thing is that the first thing we want to achieve is that we want to prove that there is a data for tracking and 3D reconstruction. So that's why we use just single event-based camera. But now we are working for a company and we want to develop practical event-based SLAM solution. So we are thinking, we believe that there is certain situation that event camera are really good, like tracking rapid motion and high dynamic range. But also, if event camera does move at all, then of course frame from the standard camera will help us. And then we don't need to get 30 frames per second for that. Maybe we can just have just one frame per second or something like that. And then IMU is good for kind of a short-term but accurate pose estimation, and it will increase our robustness of our system. That's why we have, this is the three different output from inside the SCR1 camera. Of course, the same output can get from the Davis camera. So we are really happy to have this kind of hardware, perfect hardware, we can develop our algorithm. Okay, so there is a certain kind of limitation that I can tell you in public at the moment because we are still building up our technology and as a startup. But there is a more easy way we can be more open if you are contacting us directly via our any website or contact email. And another important thing is we are looking for people who can join our company and build our vision together. So if you are interested, please have a look at the current opening on our website. And if there is anyone in this room, please talk to me or Andy or Stefan as we are here. Thank you very much.